is NDTV and you are watching NDTV Prime.
Hello and welcome to the Property Show North Edition. I'm Chanakya Bhatia. This show is just for you, your budget, our data-backed advice to help you make the right choice when making the biggest decision of your life, buying a home. With me in the studio is Sameer Jasuja, founder and MD of Prop Equity, to advise you when you call in with your questions. Here's what we have on the show today. A ground report from the top three emerging residential sectors along the Noida Expressway on why does it make sense to buy a home in these sectors. Pocket-friendly buys in Greater Noida for 35 lakh rupees. Projects from reputed developers in the upcoming sectors of Gurgaon in a crore plus budget. We will also tell you about premium residential addresses in Jaipur in a budget of 1.3 crores. Haryana government's effort to go solar has left customers in the lurch. Why has the plan gone wrong? A ground report. Why is Ascendas Singh Bridge bullish on Gurgaon's office space market? An exclusive chat coming up with India Operations Head. And our focus will be upon Noida, Gurgaon, Faridabad, the Dharuhera property market. We have Prateek Taneja on the phone line. Welcome to the Property Show. How can we help you?
Hi, Chanakya. I have a query regarding the Noida region. Mm-hmm. And specific to the sector 71 to 78, where there are a lot of builders coming up. And my query is, you know, I have a budget for 50 to 70 lakh. And I have seen through projects, Anfrix, Goldview, okay, Mahagun, and Nimbus Hyderabad. Mm-hmm. So I want to know, you know, which is the best option where I can invest for a 3BHK flat there.
Okay, perfect. So Central Noida he's looking at, and he has shortlisted some projects. So what do you think, Sameer?
Well, your budget for about 50 to 60 lakhs is a little on the lower side for a 3BHK option. However, you'll be able to easily afford a large 2BHK or a 2BHK plus 7-quarter. Most of the projects in Central Noida region are now nearing completion, so you will be able to get options when you're looking for ready opportunities from the resale market. They'll be cheaper in price as well than the developer prices, and the risk is totally mitigated in that sense. So let's look at the data points, but before that, you'd made two shortlists. Antariksh Golfview 2 is a good project. 200 families have already moved in. It's a 20-acre project. However, they have not been able to receive OC till now, and the OC is expected only when the whole project is completed, and this is being done in phases right now. So if you want to really move in and you don't want to take chances, then this is avoidable because the OC is just not there at the point at this point, and it could take any amount of time for that to happen, because whether the phase 2 gets completed or not, or gets delayed, then that will be a big risk which you can easily avoid in today's market. The second project that you shortlisted was the Hyde Park by Nimbus Projects Limited. That's a project that you can go ahead with. It's spread across 15 acres of land, total 23 towers of G plus 21 and G plus 23 stories. Project is 6.5 kilometers away from the Noida City Centre metro station. They've got a fantastic clubhouse coming up, 50,000 square feet with swimming pool, gym, steam and sauna and many other amenities. Let's look at the key data points of this micro market of Central Noida, starting with sector 70 going up to 122. Inventory overhang of 26 months, the mid-segment's weighted average price being 5150 and 5.5% being the analyzed price appreciation. There is one recommendation from our side as well, Max Royal by City Group. Another project that got ready in 2015, available in the resale market, cheaper than the options that you've kind of shortlisted. Spread over 5 acres, consisting of 9 towers. It's on the main internal road of Sector 76, around 5 kilometers from Noida City Centre. And the project offers 24/7 security and water supply, and has a club as well. Possession is already handed over and families have started to move in.
Summing up, out of your shortlisted projects, you can avoid Antariksh Goldview 2. The project is completed, but developer hasn't received OC yet. Well, on the other side, the Hyde Park project by Nimbus, you can go ahead and it gets a go ahead from our side. And other recommended project we have for you is Max Royal by Sethi Group. Next, we have an email from Madhav. He is looking for a 2 BHK flat in Noida Extension or in Faridabad. He has seen Eros Sampurnam in Noida Extension and Agman project in Faridabad. His budget is 35 lakhs and he wants possession in the next 4 months. What do you suggest, Samir?
So Sampurnam as a project is a good project. There is nothing really wrong with it. It's spread across 23 acres and is significantly a large project consisting of 42 towers. The project has comparatively one negative here, an inferior location within Noida Extension. So if you want to look at projects with better locations, there are many options available. But having said that, nothing wrong with this project. It has a huge amount of amenities as well, clubhouse with gym, swimming pool, lush green landscaping, in-house shopping center, market as well, yoga meditation center. The project pricing is also in line with the weighted average price of the market. The second project you've shortlisted, Agman, is also a project that you can go ahead with. The only risk being that today, developers, consumers are selecting projects which are almost ready. This project, the construction is yet to start. But on the face of it, nothing wrong with it. Designated affordable housing project under the HUDA affordable housing policy. That's why it's safe. The project is spread across 5.35 acres. Fantastic location for the pricing at which is coming at, which is just 2674 rupees a square foot. If you look at the weighted average price of the market, it's 3700 rupees for Greater Faridabad. So much cheaper, and Noida Extension is 3350 rupees a square foot for the mid segment. Looking at the other data points, inventory overhang of Noida Extension has shot up to 39 months now. So that's a real danger zone, and Greater Faridabad is about 22 months. Coming to a recommendation from our side as well, there is in fact two recommendations from our side. One is Fusion Homes by Tech Zone, in Tech Zone 4 Noida Extension by Fusion Biltech Limited. This project is spread across 8.9 acres of land. Phase 1 is getting ready this year itself. Amenities include pool, gym, banquet hall, sports facilities, pool decks, etc. The second project is Sri Radha Sky Garden by Sri Group, Sector 16B, Noida Extension. This project is spread across 16.5 acres. Project is in two phases. Phase 1 has 8 towers. Amenities here include clubhouse with sports facilities, swimming pool, health club, gym, retail area and skating rink. And any of these two projects you can go ahead with.
Okay, summing up, the projects which you have shortlisted, Eros Sampurnam in Noida Extension gets a go-ahead from our side, but the project is a bit far, whereas construction in Agman project in Faridabad has not even started yet. Therefore, it does not fit your requirement. Other projects which we are recommending you are in Noida Extension only, Fusion Homes by Fusion Biltech Limited, Sri Radha Sky Garden by Sri Group. And in our efforts to help you find and identify best property in your budget, today we cruise markets in the Noida region, which have the potential to fit your budget with infrastructure in place. Take a look. When it comes to infrastructure, there's one stretch which wins hands down in the National Capital Region, and that's the Noida Greater Noida Expressway. This stretch has seen abundance of real estate supply in the last 5 years and holds out a solid potential for the future, both for residential and commercial development. Today, sectors 137, 143 and 168 are the preferred destination for home buyers who want to buy a budget ready-to-move-in flat. Take a look at the prices. At an average of 5,000 rupees per square foot, a spacious two-bedroom can come at a price tag of 50 to 60 lakh rupees. There are over 13,000 ready-to-move-in units in these three sectors, while many more are under construction. For this affordable destination, an under-construction metro which lands in Sector 137 and 143 is the biggest plus. An under-construction Ghaziabad-Noida link which will further enhance connectivity. IT parks, schools and hospitals add to the livability index.
If you look at the commercial which is developed currently, it's mostly in the 137-128, which is our initial sector. And the residential which is close by, which is 93-94, has become very costly. The current rate going there is around 6,000-7,000, which makes it unaffordable for new buyers. That's why people are willing to move a little further away. And the sectors 137, 143, 160, which are very close by, they are the ones which are coming up, because also there is going to be connectivity of metro, which is already planned and work is going on.
There are projects by several reputed developers who are offering decent amenities. And with each one of them eyeing a boost in sales this festive season, it might be the best time to strike a good deal here. Chanakya Bhatia for NDTV. Moving on, we have an email from Sachin Tyagi. He is interested in 2 BHK flat in Cloud 9, Vaishali, Ghaziabad. And he wants guidance on the possession and the feasibility of the project. And his budget is 50 to 60 lakh rupees. Samir, what do you suggest?
Well, the budget is slightly on the lower side for 2 BHK apartments. The weighted average price of Vaishali is roughly about 6,100 rupees a square foot. So there are fewer options available due to smaller 2 BHK sizes can fit in your budget. So this project fits in very well though, although it's at 6,000 rupees a square foot, but the sizing is smaller. 2 BHK is as small as 930 square feet here. It's a mixed land use development project offering retail space in a shopping complex, studio apartments and residential apartments. Project has a total saleable area of 1.1 million square feet. Thus, it is very large and has two clubhouses with two swimming pools, recreational facilities and many more options over here in terms of amenities. Let's look at the key data points. Vaishali is a safe micro market even for under construction properties because very limited supply. It's almost a readily developed secondary market now, 18 months of inventory overhang, and Indirapuram is slightly higher on the inventory overhang side with more supply at 28 months. The mid-segment's weighted average price for Vaishali, as I mentioned, is 6,100 rupees, but Indirapuram is a nearby colony which is as good, almost at 5,150 rupees a square foot, which will really fit well in your budget. And if you start looking at the analyzed appreciation figures, Vaishali is at 6.5% and Indirapuram is 5.6%. Coming to two more options, Panchil Pebbles by Panchil Biltech is a small project spread across 2 acres of land, a total of 3 towers. Project is mixed stage of construction. Amenities here include clubhouse, gym, garden, lawn, indoor games, pool area. And AVJ Amba Homes by AVJ Group, Indirapuram is 4,800 rupees a square foot spread across 3.5 acres of land. Amenities here include clubhouse with swimming pool, jogging track, kids play area, yoga center, and reserved car parking. So any of these three projects you can go ahead with.
Okay, so it's a go ahead for Cloud 9 by Rishabh Group. Other options in your budget are Panchil Pebbles by Panchil Biltech and AVJ Amba Homes by AVJ Group. Next we have Raja Bhattacharya on the phone line. Welcome to the Property Show. What is your query?
Thank you, sir. I just wanted to know that I was looking for a property for end use purpose. Mm-hmm. And I have identified one particular property. Okay. My budget is 1.4 CR.
Okay. So your location preference is Gurgaon?
Yeah, my preference is Gurgaon and Noida, Gurgaon Golf Course Extension Road.
Okay. So in his email also, he has mentioned that he has identified one project, which is Pioneer Park, and he's looking at Golf Course Extension Road. Is this budget enough for that particular place? I guess it's...
So Pioneer Park definitely is a great project with a fantastic location just in the beginning of Golf Course Extension, attaching to the Golf Course Road. That side is what I'm talking about. The project is good for end use. It's a large project of 75 acres, mixed land use development, which is going to offer high street shopping, retail, as well as offices besides the school as well. Located bang on Sector 61, adjacent, as I said, to the golf course. Township has more than 10 acres of green area alone. Of course, the clubhouse is fully there as well. Project is also ready. It's just that the electricity has not come over there, and today only diesel generators are being used, and the cost of that is very, very high. So if you immediately move in, you'll have to keep that in mind, but nothing really wrong with the project. Coming to the key data points of both the micro markets, one we've shortlisted for you that would fit your budget as well. Golf Course Extension Road has today 18 months of inventory overhang, and sectors between Sona Road and NHO8 is 20 months. The mid to luxury segment's weighted average price for Golf Course Extension is 8,500 rupees, and between Sona Road and NHO8 is 6,650 rupees a square foot. The Golf Course Extension Road's price appreciation is 7-odd%, whereas the sectors between Sona Road and NHO8 is 5.3% on an analyzed basis. There are two more recommendations from our side. One is Kion by IREO, a project again almost ready, part of a larger township of IREO City spanning 500 acres. The project has modern amenities like clubhouse, swimming pool, gym, children's play area, high-tech features as well. And lastly, we have Space Privy by Space Limited, 7120 rupees a square foot. This is in Sector 72. Project is spread across 11 acres of land. Project has 9 blocks. Amenities include pool, health club, jogging and walking tracks, 100% power backup, and recently completed project possession handed over in late 2014.
And talking about these areas like Gurgaon region, well, circle rate was slashed, and if someone wants to buy a new property, Sameer, I guess this is the right time to go and negotiate and get a good rate.
Absolutely. If you can buy end use properties today, which are almost ready or really ready, this is the best time to buy. Prices are not going to go down any further. And there are a lot of investors stuck, and there's a great opportunity for you to look at giving them an exit and you getting in at the right price.
And even the projects which we have recommended are from the resale market.
Yes.
So resale market, you can get a better rate.
Yes, typically all the projects that we are recommending mostly are from the resale market.
Okay, so summing up, a Pioneer Park by Pioneer Urban Land gets a go-ahead from our side. Other projects which we are recommending in your budget are a Skyon by REO and a Space Privy by Space Limited. Next query is from Jayendra, who is joining us from the phone line. Go ahead with your question.
Okay, I would like to buy 2 BHK flat in Gurgaon on NH8. My budget is around 35 to 40 lakhs.
Okay.
I've seen one project, Dwarkadish Aravali Heights in Dharuhera.
Okay.
So can you please advise me for that?
Okay, so after a very long time, we are getting queries about Dharuhera and Bhiwadi locations. So Dharuhera as a property market, how is it performing at the moment?
So, Dharuhera as a property market, we'll come to in a bit. First, we'll talk about the project that you've shortlisted. Ravli Heights is a good choice for end users. Pricing is fantastic. Dwarkadish Projects is one of the reputed developers of the Dharuhera region. This project anyway has zero execution risk. It's been ready since 2013. Amenities are also decent. Swimming pool, community center at this price point of 2400 or 2600 rupees. It's a steal. 60 to 70% occupancy level has been achieved in this project as well. The market as we speak right now is in deep distress, and plenty of discounts are available from desperate sellers, as we were mentioning, in the resale markets. So look out for those, and this could be probably one of the good times to buy as an end user. Coming to the data points of this micro market, inventory over hang of 14 months, the mid segment's weighted average price of 2900 rupees, and the analyzed return are about 6% for the Dharuhera market. Two more recommendations from our side: Parkview Delight by Bestech Group. This project is a part of 56 acres integrated development. The Bestech City is an amalgamation of plots in various convenient sizes. The township is surrounded by sector road from three sides and minimum 12 meters wide within the city. And lastly, we have Vipul Gardens by Vipul Limited. This is a project spread across 13.3 acres, located bang on NHO8 in Sector 1, Dharuhera. Amenities here include club with gym, TTs, steam, jacuzzis, swimming pool, multifunction hall. Everything is available here as well.
And talking about the market, how is it performing?
As I mentioned earlier, the market is in deep distress, and this is probably the best time to buy for end users. Lots of availability, supply has been large, and even though it's a very highly affordable market, but somewhere supply has exceeded the demand here as well.
And even the selling of industrial units, it has increased. The government has, now the policies are in favor of industries setting up in that particular locality. So job creation will be there, so rental accommodation will also increase.
It's already, like I mentioned, the supply has already outstripped the demand. So the rental accommodation is also going to be definitely there in place as we speak as well. As there are a lot of investors who are stuck, so if they can't sell their properties, they're going to be offering them on rent as well.
Okay, so plenty of supply in that region. Going solar is high on the BJP government's agenda. It is also offering 30% subsidy on installations. But a launch of half-baked policies, as in the case of Haryana government, has left customers in the lurch and government officials red-faced, scrambling for answers. Onita Moja has the story.
Dr. Akhil Mahajan invested 5 lakh rupees to install this solar rooftop panel in his house in Sector 28, Faridabad. He was worried that long power cuts would hamper his son's studies, who was preparing for the medical entrance test. While installing the rooftop turned out to be a savior for their son, who cleared his exams without facing any power outages, it did leave the Mahajans immensely exasperated.
The sanction should be done within 2-3 days. In my case, it has not been given even for 1.5 years. The sanction is not still here, and I have written to each and every quarter of the country, from Prime Minister to CM to the Secretary MNRE. I have met each and every person till now. If I have not been able to get the subsidy.
The Haryana government announced its solar policy in 2014, making solar panels mandatory for houses built over 500 square yards. The government also promised 30% subsidy on the total project cost, which simply hasn't materialized because of lack of any process in place. When contacted, Haryana government official in charge of the solar policy admitted not enough groundwork was done, leaving several deficiencies in the policy. To begin with, the state does not have trained technical staff to handle highly specialized energy forms such as solar. The policy was launched without putting in place a panel of vendors to sell net meters. The billing software in the power stations is not updated to calculate solar energy import and export. This made customers like Dr. Mahajan pay more instead of paying less. The subsidy claims process involves too much paperwork and bureaucracy.
There's a lot of complexity in everything, and because of many stakeholders in this process, I feel that, you know, the process and the progress of the thing is satisfactory, though we need to increase the speed and, you know, resolve any issues which are there in these all the five stakeholders.
Alarmed by the fact that only 54 applications have been received for subsidy so far, which indicates that the policy has been a non-starter, Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar convened a high-level meeting last month. It is only after that that work has begun in earnest and gaps are being plugged. In Gurgaon, Oinitham Oja, NDTV.
Well, now it's time to take a break. After we come back, we will tap premium residential locations of Jaipur and smart investment options in promising destinations of Lucknow. That's coming up after a break. Also, a new launch of Prakriti Shanti Niketan in Sector 144 along the Noida Expressway region in our property tracker.